early drive. Really bad. Oh, tea just spilt. Let's put chia seeds in my tea. Oh, I'm so lucky. Bird crapped on my window, crapped on my car. I'm so lucky. Drop unexpectedly like bird shit. Man, it's messing this car. I mean, what do you expect? I drive it like all the time. Giving you nothing but the real. Real. Hips hops, hips hops. Tip top. Early drive. Look a little tired. Because it's early. Gotta go to the bank, 9 o'clock. Get me some cash. Oh, I forgot. Maybe I'll show it later. I was gonna, welcome to a New Jersey drive, riding with Jesus. Jesus saved. And maybe because I look so tired, maybe I should put on the glasses. What looks better? Purple or red? Yeah, let's go with red. Got some kind of burgundy look here. Yeah. Alright. Subject that watched a is based on I forgot about her largely. Teal Swan, I remember I fell into the rabbit hole of just looking into the personality cult of Teal Swan, and she appears to be a very genuine spiritual woman that had went through hell. I saw the interview. She talked about the satanic sex abuse that she suffered. Man. What is with these people, man, that do shit like that? What the fuck is with them? And prompted by a Teal Swan video, she was talking about containment and that women need it in a relationship with men. And I don't like the word containment because there's a con in it. And then tame, like keep things tame. And then ment, as it were. Anything with tainment in it seems like it's kind of like, well, maybe if it was calm-tainment, because calm means together, and a con is, I don't have to describe that to you, do I? When you con somebody, you have a conversation, try to flip, But, semantics aside, she talks about how women need this sort of, they need this sort of base in a relationship, of course, for security and everything. Containment. And it's a good video. Good talking. She you could tell all this stuff is written down and she's just telling it. Basically saying that if a man can't be able to provide this for a woman, then she's Splitsville. I look at my past relationships and I'm like, yep, failed to do that. And that's good, because it's a lesson. And we're learning lessons every day. I wrote it down, but shoot, Michelangelo, I'm still learning. Destruction of the family unit is what they want. You know, they want to destroy the family. You know, you got my family. You got my brother with fucking. You know, you just can't talk about politics with. Everything is about race and identity. One time he went to a restaurant, my father and mother, and. The waitress or the waiter, black, and my brother openly said to him, you know, Dad, you need to check your privilege. And it was like, what? You know, I'm omitting some details here because I don't remember the whole conversation, but he told my dad to check his privilege. I was just like, what the fuck is that? What a weird thing to say, man. It's like, chill out, and, you know, my parents bought him dinner. So there's that, you know. It's like, whoa, check your privilege, dude, you know. Ball's in your court, bud. Now you need to take the shot. But, you know, yeah, he just, you know, he's just, he's under the guise that, oh, we're going to have, you know, first... I'm not gonna get into it. It's stupid stuff. It's just spiritually, it just destroys. It just drains you. Oh, camera just did a little slide on its own. But the family unit. Where are we getting this? You know, I really, respect and honor my sister, man. She, you know, she went. She had like a. You know, all young girls, man. They really got it fucking hard, man. You know, when they go through the growing pains and then have them go through high school or even earlier than that, you know, they get you at fifth grade. But man, my sister, man, she went through like this, like self-destruction, like all the sort of things that they do in teen years, you know? And I went through some of that stuff as well, but as a girl, you know, it's fucking turned up even higher and more. You know, more than it is for a young boy. And these people just zip around here. They don't give a fuck. They're coming down a hill. You know, went through that. And now she's... It took her a while, but she's married. To an awesome husband. Who makes his own coins, by the way. And he works two jobs. This poor guy, man, he's just got anxiety every day, you know? And I pray for him. Pray for the family. My sister's got a beautiful little boy. You know, baby boy. He got blonde hair and he's got blue eyes and he's just, he's funny. He calls bullshit on people. And he's, you know, like a little baby, he's calling bullshit. just awesome, you know, and I'm an uncle, you know, and at first I was like, I don't like that word, but now I'm like, yeah, coming around it, you know, I haven't seen him in some time, you know, especially now since I'm working like 6 days a week, everything to do with that job is 666, except me. And a bunch of other people spreading the good word, you know. Jesus saves. Hallelujah. Huzzah. But, you know, she's got a beautiful family. They work, you know, and that's what you gotta do when you got a family, man. Shit, you know. Unless otherwise, you know, you get off your grid, but they're on it. flag outside their house. And she's just like a credible mom, you know, just to, you know, I hear him with him, with the little baby, you know, and the little, you know, very much attached, the little guy's really attached to the mom, you know, he's getting to be a little tough guy too, you know, trying to figure out how things work with his little baby mind. Let me tell you something, man, babies are probably the closest thing to being like a genius, because fuck, man, they just was created, they just came from the source, you know, in a flash of light, you know, sperm meeting an egg. Babies is like, yo, when I first met this little dude, I was looking intently into his eyes like, yo, you know something I don't know, what can I learn from you? And as a result, you know, he took a shine to me, you know, because I wasn't trying to condescend and be like, baby, ooh, doo, doo. I was seriously like, yo, what do you know? What do you know? Can you communicate to me? Something telepathic? I don't know. You know, there's got to be something that, you know, that you can tell me. Like, I'm trying to learn from this little dude, you know, because he was just in it, you know, the source. Astralites, everything, just pure, you know? And that's why they do that satanic shit, because they know there's fucking, they know babies know something, and they got this sort of energy, so they try to get it out of the baby. Like some thieving motherfuckers. But me, I'm generally like, yo, whoa, this baby, man. And then if you got a clear mind, if you go clairvoyant, I got little telepathic messages from him. And that's between me and that little dude. You don't need to be going this other fucking route and doing shit like that. That shit is uncalled for. That shit is unnecessary. If you do that, you're gonna get exposed and we gonna find out who the fuck you is. Because that's some, oh man, there ain't words for it. There ain't an English word for it, man. These fucking crazy fucking dipstick meddling bast witch motherfuckers doing that shit to little pure babies, man. God's babies, God's children. What the fuck is going on with these people in their minds, man? And it's real. It's real. The shit is happening, folks. So, pray for the protection of all God's children, all God's babies, you know? Sick, sick, deluded motherfuckers. That's what they do, man. They light the pentagram on fire. And they do that shit. Oh, man, I'm getting sidetracked. Whoop. Oh. Yo, fuck them. Ill. Lose. Shun. Motherfuckers. Doing shit like that, preying on innocent babies. Man, I'm doing this just before I'm about to walk into bank. Shit is real, you know. Shit is real. When you fucking finally see it, shit is real. You gotta live with this motherfucking shit, and you gotta fucking be the ones to do exposing. Cause shit is real. Said one time to this lady as I was getting some shit, I was like, man, I'll take these items and I'm gonna rob a bank. And then I fucking shouldn't have said that, because in this day and age people may think it's serious. I ain't John Dillinger. I'm just John Lennon Allison. Ah. Let's get you something to look at.
still rolling?
Yeah. Well, this is my mask. I wore it the whole lockdown. There's just only been a handful of places that don't like that, and this was one of them. So I brought a spare bandana. You know, what's better than wearing a mask? You know, I like the gator, the bandana, and then this is the default mask. I always wear this one. And then when I get, somebody says something, you know, it's like, okay, let's have a conversation then, you know? But this one, it was like kind of clear. It's like, you can't cover your face up fully in a bank. But this is a mask. And if they tell me it's a Halloween mask, I always say, nope, I wore this the whole lockdown. To me, it's a memento mori. Because you walk out every day, you walk out your house, you risking your life every day. Oh yeah, here's a song. I like this. I love this song. It's had to give me some cash. I'm trying to make this a cashless society. These little bills, magic money. Man, I didn't even count it. I just took her word for it. Oh, she got the banker lady. She, Benviva. I mean, she didn't say her name. I don't know how to pronounce it. But she's like, got plaques and stuff. Little rock star, trophy. And I was like, you know, man, I'm just a real friendly guy, man. I was just like, oh shit, you kicking ass, you know? And I was telling them about COVID-19 and how bullshit it is. She's like, sir, I need you to wear this surgical mask. I said, now I worked in a hospital. It's not sanitary to be wearing these things all the time. It's symbolic, you know? No, you know, I'm not wearing that. Just talking about how much bullshit this whole thing is. I mean, it's, COVID's there, but like, fucking A, man. You know, the precautions you're taking for it is just like bullshit, you know? It's like magic land, you know? Like, for instance, I worked in a hospital, I told the lady this. Yo, when the first SARS epidemic broke out, I was working in a hospital. I had to transport patients from room to room, you know, or I had to go in the room and get them and take them to their tests, you know. That was my function at that particular job. And every time I had to go in a room, you had to mask up, gown up, do all the precautions, you know, gloves, all that. Even, you know, covering your hair, you know, or put little booties on your shoes, you know, for the SARS patients or the MRSA patients. And sometimes the nurses, they didn't tell you. And you'd be walking into a room and all of a sudden you see the patient and you're like, you know, so I always asked, it's like, yo, is this patient, what's the deal, you know? But you had to mask up, gown up, and all that. And you had to do that for every patient. Meaning, it wasn't sanitary to, like, go in another patient's room with the mask and gown that you wore prior to seeing the other patient. So you had to disrobe and discard all this stuff. You know, it was seen as unsanitary if you wore a mask for like more than like an hour, you know? But lo and behold, today with the deadly COVID-19 and the pandemic, conspiracy theorists say that you gotta be wearing a mask every time you go places. And it could be the same fucking mask. You don't gown up or nothing, but fuck, man, you know? One day you'll be able to hug your grandparents if you take that eugenics vax. Oh, man, a lot of people at work, when I hear they take it, I go, oh, shit, you know? I wonder if they talk about me, because I'm very, you know, vocal about it. Like, no fucking way am I taking that shit. But their arms get like, I've seen a tough guy. I probably told this story in another video. I don't know what I say in some of these videos, man. It sounds like a repeater. 1, 2, 3, repeater. But these people got their dog walking in the street, and they're walking on the sidewalk. What the heck? But you know, I've seen this tough guy. He does all the stock work, man. He took the shot, and this brother's doing it with one arm. All the work. He couldn't even lift his fucking arm, man. And that's what happens to all these people, man, that take the shot. And this is the Moderna. Yo, I don't know what this guy's doing. Oh, okay. It's not like I gotta go to work or anything. Shit. My glasses are behind my head. Alright, I'm gonna have to go around this guy. I gotta go to work, but can't be waiting for your truck to be backing up into somebody's driveway like a weirdo. I should have nothing but love for truck drivers, because I might take that job. The guy with a camo on just like grilling me. What is this? Let it get my COVID pandemic vibes or something. But yeah, people, it's a sham. We're falling for it. Well, the lot of you are falling for it because you don't know any better. You don't know how to do your own due diligence. You fucking lame ducks, you know? You fucking buy into anything, man. Suckers. Fools. First, the zero card in the tarot deck. That's what you is. Buying into this boom. I don't know what else you can say about you. Just do your own fucking research, man. You know? I put out some shit there that I followed the damn thing. I followed it from day zero. I did. I was one of them people that was like, you know, the sky is falling. Because all them fear-mongering videos that were popping up from China, I was just like, oh shit, it's on. And I was listening to Dark Throne, Panzerfrost. I had my ex relationship with her. I was warning her, you know. Her parents were like, it's going to be nothing but the flu, you know. Or I was there when they fucking threw up the John Hopkins University map. And we all were watching it. The little red dots appearing. Yeah, and then, you know, the first time I ever heard of John Hopkins University, and now I know what the fuck they is, and I know who they're connected to, and I know how this motherfucking thing works. Thank you, all essential workers. More propaganda. I work in a supermarket. Essential worker. You know? What am I supposed to brag about it? Do I get a raise? Nah, man, I'm working minimum wage, man. That's how essential workers work, right? They get paid minimum wage. These mass shamers, mask on, newcomer. I used to look up to this guy. I can't even listen to his music without thinking about his fucking Twitter feed, where he just takes pictures of workers without a mask and mask shames them. And, oh yeah, I said that in another video. Yeah, bougie motherfucker. This guy, I don't know what the hell is wrong with this guy. Definitely not riding with Jesus. That guy's riding with Biden. Good luck with that. I see all these like pro-Biden tweets and everything, man. It's like last night, you know, on the fucking Twitter feed, what was trending, Trump to Biden, and people were comparing it like getting like a, I don't know, think of the most gourmet dish after you just had some hot dogs. You know, and you got your little champagne. I'm like, what the fuck are these people smoking, you know? What the fuck is they smoking, man? gotta be like angel dust. No, helium dust or something, man. What the fuck is you smoking to make you say some weird shit like that? You comparing people to meals? What the fuck is... Where's you? Man, where am I turning at? You know, that whole algorithm thing on Twitter is just all control bullshit, you know? They just throw up some things. And they're still talking about Trump, man. They're still talking about him. They're trying to really scratch the bottom of the barrel, you know, for some kind of news, because they know that's the only news they got. Biden just... fucking boring and see-through, man. People know exactly what that administration is about, because you already fucking went through it, you know. Yeah, ladies. I might take that chair. Yeah, maybe I'll take that chair she got out there. Too. Kind of got a weakness for ladies in all black leggings doing gardening work. Well, that might be her husband, I don't know. let's see if this... I just got myself a nice chair and met the beautiful spirit there, Marianne. Told her she looked like Patti Smith. She does. Mistaken her for a very young woman from the back. You know, beautiful woman. However, she was telling me, you know, we disagreed to a point where it was talking about spreading the word and unification. Like, my thing has been, I just roll up the different churches, you know? And she was saying, you gotta get rooted. You gotta get a fellowship with one church. See, this is what happened. This is like a thing that happened in Occupy Wall Street. I was with many tribes. I met many people. And as a result, you know, maybe, she, you know, there is some truth to what she's saying, but like, I don't know. I'm just rogue, you know? I mean, I'm Gambit. I'm constantly, you know? I just meet people in life and then I just continue on. I met so many cool people, man. And I don't got, you know, I don't got their telephones or telephone numbers or nothing, but we had some great times. You know, some spiritual experiences. And, you know, that's just what I do. I just... saves, you know. She didn't like the she didn't agree with the, you know, Jesus is a Jesus tried to learn all kinds of different religions, which, you know, is true, but she didn't agree with that. Didn't like it when I said that, like, because I started talking about Catholicism and she was just not trying to hear any of that. The 100-year deal with the God made with the devil. How else? How else? You gotta be open, you know? Everybody's got their own kind of religion. Alright. What a cool morning. I don't know. Maybe that's enough for today. Yeah, interesting. Yeah, really beautiful person, though. Yeah, man. And, you know, what's amazing is that, you know, when you ride with Jesus, Jesus saves. Man. She was like, I don't know, she had to have been in her 80s or 70s or something. She's talking about disco.